It's been a whole year? My, my, how the time drags. Well, anyway, 2021, here we are. We've been locked in our bedrooms for, like, the past 12 months, I guess, with little better to do than look at our timelines. It may have been bad for socializing and shit, but seems to have been good for music. Lots of artists going that extra mile to give us something good to stream. I have no way of knowing how long this wave of strong popular music is gonna last, but I've certainly been enjoying it. So much so that, once again, we're gonna be splitting up the honorable mentions. Let's go! This sounds like America. The 70s band America. Especially that doo-doo-doo part. Anything that reminds me of them is a positive. Blue cheese, I swear I'm addicted to blue cheese. Oh, I get it. Blue cheese is a strain of marijuana. That's pretty clever, good sir. Can I just say that I love that dark, spooky noise? It's so intriguingly sinister. That's my best friend. She a real bad bitch, drive her own car. This one is so much fun. Look at how much fun they're having in our 2021. This is what the end of the pandemic is gonna be like. Just you wait. Is that my bestie in a taxi? Yeah, but all I brought back with me was some sand in my boots. Everyone seems to say that this is the best track from his album, and yeah, I agree. It's a really heartbreaking song about the end of a vacation fling, a summer romance that wasn't. And look, I'd like to give Morgan Wallen the benefit of the doubt, I really would. I'm sure he really is taking the steps to stop drinking and improve himself as a person, but I'll believe it when I see it. When you're kicked out of Kid Rock's bar, that's... yeah. Begging for you to take my hand. Evermore was pretty good. If Nobody No Crime had still been charting, it would have made the list. But this one, I also liked. Alright, enough fucking around. Let's get to the really good ones. If it's up, then it's up, then it's up, then it's stuck. If it's up, then it's up, then it's up, then it's stuck.
My driver's license last week, just like we always talked about.
Screw it, I'm putting driver's license on the best list.
And I know we weren't perfect, but
even if you include all the gossip and response songs, driver's license is still very much real. And that concept of, I just got my driver's license and I'm sad because we were gonna do all these fun things but we can't because you dumped me, definitely hits me right in my teenage heart. Especially that one line.
You said forever, now I drive alone past your street.
Yeah, it's very much a teenager line, but the sentiment is still every bit as real. And that sound of a car powering down as an instrument.
I ever love someone else.
Just awesome. But even though I liked it, I didn't start thinking highly of it until this.
Yes, it's about a girl getting her driver's license, but it's bittersweet because it's something she and her ex always talked about. That's what I guess based on hearing it for the first time right now.
That is a recent SNL skit in which a bunch of guys in a pool hall are listening to driver's license and having a heated discussion about it. This is exactly how I imagine a Billboard Twitter meetup, by the way. Especially when everyone sings along with the bridge.
Red lights, stop signs, I still see your face.
And I think more than that, it illustrates that music, whether classic or modern, can still be enjoyed by people young and old. Speaking as someone in his late 30s making videos about crap that teenagers listen to, it really goes to show just how universal a language music can be. In other words, be like the SNL cast.
You said forever, now I drive alone past your street. If it's up, then it's up, then it's up, then it's stuck. If it's up, then it's
guys are kind of sleeping on Miley Cyrus's comeback. Probably because I'm sure some of you still think of her as that nasty freak who twerked on the VMAs. That was what, 7 years ago, 8 years ago? It's time to heal. Prisoner, unfortunately, didn't do very well on the Hot 100, but did just well enough on Global that it could make it on the list. That's another reason I like to use the Global charts as well. Cause otherwise, I'd have missed out on this awesomeness. It may not be as good as Midnight Sky, but Prisoner still slaps. And Miley and Dua Lipa complement each other well. It's another one of those where I get the feeling they should start a supergroup. And of course, it still has that early 80s vibe. I mean, we've been doing this 80s nostalgia thing for a long-ass fucking time. It should have been played out by now. But the thing about that decade is, there was so much going on at once, and so many flavors, it's almost like it's designed to never wear out. And as long as it's done well, yeah, I would be on board with sounding like the 80s for decades to come. Even if it's Hannah Montana carrying the torch into the new 20s. If it's up, then it's up, then it's up, then it's stuck. If it's up, then it's up, then it's up, then it's stuck. Yeah, this is gonna be my weeb music pick. Sure, I could put Yoasobi on the list again, but nah. I felt like having some rock on here. Since this crap is what passes for rock in America, the so-called greatest nation in the world, I'd rather get my rock somewhere else. This opening theme to Jujutsu Kaisen, yeah, this is what I like to think of when rock comes to mind. By the way, I haven't seen it yet. I've been meaning to get back into anime for a while now, so maybe I'll check it out when I'm done with this video. But it's just so awesome that thanks to the Global 200, we now have anime themes charting on Billboard. But yeah, this crushing guitar and speedy percussion, this is what rock sounds like. Anyway, feel free to suggest some animes in the comment section. I'm open to anything. If it's up, then it's up, then it's up, then it's stuck. If it's up, then it's up, then it's up, then it's stuck. No hopeful girl like me, I'll come and be winning. Yeah. I call this one Girl Like Me, the good version. It's got a nice guitar and some vocals that actually sound like vocals. I don't get why this one isn't squatting on our charts like the other one is, but whatever, I'm just a stupid chart watcher, what the hell do I know? I'll say this, I know what I like. You said that I've been acting different, yeah, funny how I finally flipped the script on you. And boy do I like this. This is some nice soulful shit. That beat is damn good, and the singer really sells it. Especially with that hook. Don't forget to come and pick up your feelings. Damn, she's not just kicking you out of the house. She's demanding that you take your feelings with you too. Jasmine Sullivan ain't fucking around. That's for goddamn sure. And holy shit, can she really mean it? New phone. Who is it? Contact. You know, I don't think I've ever really looked into Jasmine Sullivan's catalog. I know she's been around since the late 2000s, but I can't say I've ever sat down and listened to anything she's ever done. Her biggest hit appears to be Bust Your Windows, almost cracking the top 30. Let's take a listen. I bust the windows out your car. Ooh, she's tough as fuck. Yeah, this is about how she gets revenge on her cheating asshole by smashing the shit out of his car. And even that doesn't help because she still has to deal with her broken heart. I gotta say, it's a lot more realistic than when Carrie Underwood did it. Don't leave no pieces. But back to Pick Up Your Feelings, it seems to be kind of slow to catch on. I'm not counting on it doing well enough to make the year-end list, but I do hope it sticks around for at least 20 weeks or so. Monster on the worst list, and now we have a good monster on the best list. And as a bonus, this one's from Hometown Heroes All Time Low. Another day, another headache, in this hangover hotel. In this one, the monster is a toxic relationship that the guy just keeps coming back to. I know the common response is, well, why don't you just fucking leave them? Why do I run back to you like I don't mind if you fuck up my life? But as someone who has been in one of those kinds of relationships, it's really not that simple. We've all been there. We know that if we stay, there could be trouble, but we're also really afraid that if we go, it would be double. Oh yeah, and that douchebag Black Bear is on this too. Thinking I don't care who I might hurt along the way, I'm fucking sinking. He's alright on this, I guess. Maybe he would do better in alternative rock music. Oh, and speaking of people who would do well in rock music. Thinking about you, you're in my head. Even without you, I still feel dead. Demi Lovato sounds good on this. Like, really good. Her voice got a sharp edge to it that really matches well with the crushing music. Why do we sleep where we want to hide? The powers combine to make something that really should get a lot more love than it seems to be getting. Like, this deserves to be a monster hit. See what I did there? I don't mind if you fuck up my life.
Grubhub Perks give you deals on the food you love. The kind of deals that make you boogie. Take my order, cause your body like a carry-out. Let me walk into your body till you hear me out. Turn me on, my baby, don't you cut me out. Turn me on, my baby, don't you cut me out. Take my order, cause your body like a carry-out. And let me walk into your body till it's out. Turn me on, my baby, don't you cut me out. Turn me on, my baby, don't you cut me out. Don't you cut me out.
My paycheck and it's time to shop. Wow, video equipment too? Time to stock up on new CDs. I've been looking for this import everywhere. Wait, what's in this room? Wow, look at these sound systems. Let me just turn one up. Sound City's got it all. I mean, cordless phones, answering machines, pagers, portable sound systems. Whoa, and of course, car stereos. Sound City in Bayonne, where hearing is believing.
Joey, we've got a new angle. A more low-key approach we'd like you to try, okay? Four-piece bedroom set, $549. Quality sofa, $399. Mattress and box spring, $59. Complete futon, $169. Twin full bunk bed, $188. We will not be undersold.
So you think you can handle this?
Sleep Cheap Furniture in Jersey City and now in Hoboken. Fast delivery, large selection, and the cheapest prices in the country!
God. What is this, and would anyone like to join me in building a religion around it? From here on out, it's gonna be 5 out of 5s, starting with this chill as fuck track. Sounds like if the Miami Sound Machine decided they're gonna relax. No conga, no rhythm out to get you. Just sitting on the beach at night watching the waves. That's exactly the kind of vibe that I get from this. I know nothing about Cali Uchis or the language she's singing in, and maybe I really don't want to know. I suppose we could look up a translation though. Yep, it's a love song, alright. One about how love is such a universal language, it can be expressed by ESP. On TikTok, she said that the point is that you can still be feeling love for someone, even if you can't physically be there. And is that a sentiment for the times we've been living in, or what? It's definitely all about the atmosphere with this one. She wasn't kidding when she said she was sending telepathic love to all with this one. And when you think about it, isn't all content a form of telepathic love? Like, maybe this channel is my way of sending telepathic love to all of you. Food for thought?
Our kitchen, where I cooked your favorite food.
When I said I would use the Rolling Stone chart, I didn't promise that I would have used them the last time. Well, I have found that Rolling Stone kinda works like the Hot 100 in the future. Let me explain. Here's the March 20th Hot 100. Notice the top three are all debuts. And of course, all three of them are Drake. Yeah, let's just give him some more chart records. Just keep feeding the beast. Now, here's the Rolling Stone 100 from the date of this video, March 6th. Same top three, same Drake songs. So, as epic as it is to see all top three debuts on Billboard, Rolling Stone did it first. Oh, and there's something else Billboard did on the 20th. Something Rolling Stone also did first. That's right, both weeks, the top four were all debuts. And what a number four debut it is! I'ma leave the door open. I'ma leave the door open. Ah, fuck yes. The glorious Bruno Mars, king of the throwback sounds. He's living proof that just because you ran out of 80s, doesn't mean you can't still throw it back. This time around, he's taken us all back to that wonderful Philly soul sound. Tell me that you're coming through. Just lovely. If the artist's name on this was the Delphonics, I swear I would have believed it. But there's one other thing that makes this so great. And that thing is Anderson Dot Pack. Anderson Pack is one of those artists I say that I like, but I haven't listened to as much as I should. If you smoke, what you smoke? I got the haze. And if you're hungry, girl, I got the lace. The guy has talent. He is an artistic genius. He should have been a big name by now, but he hasn't had that breakthrough just yet. Not until 2021, when he rode the Bruno Mars coattail to success. They even do the la 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 thing that the Delphonics do. I gotta say, I am so glad this is getting traction. If this somehow fails to make the year-end chart, then we all need to sit down and have a really long, hard talk about what kind of society we truly want to be. Is Circles still so great? Well, because it is, really. I mentioned how it reminds me of 70s rock, but getting a closer look at it, what it really reminds me of is 70s George Harrison. All I got to do is to love you. I mean, with a harder edge, but yeah, Circles does sound a lot like something George Harrison would have made in the 70s. And you know, we really don't give his solo career enough love. Now, we gotta have something that sounds like something George Harrison would have made in the 80s. Like, something that maybe would have also been made by his BFF Jeff Lynne. Well, now we have something like that. I saw you dancing in a crowded room. And it comes to us from you know who. The Grammys really fucked up on this one. You know how I said there were enough flavors of 80s sounds to go around? This is another one. The George Harrison / ELO 80s. Right down to that part towards the end. Tell me you don't hear this on an ELO album. Tell me this would sound out of place on Time. I don't know why. It's also got that kind of production that sounded like it came from Cloud 9, which is really underrated, by the way. This combines to make a track that's right up there with Blinding Lights. The kind of thing that should have at least been nominated for a Grammy. I realize that I'm much too late, and you deserve someone better. Even though the winners turned out to be mostly unobjectionable, this is still not a good look for the Grammys. It stands as yet another example of the Grammys getting it wrong. And now he's boycotting the Grammys forever. I'm with you, man. Fuck the Grammys. Megan Thee Stallion just keeps getting better and better. I'll put it like this. I had Crybaby on the worst list because it's funny bad. That crying sound is annoying, but I can't help but chuckle at it. It's also kinda cute how they both brag about their sex lives over it. But this one, I not only chuckle at, I also can't help but smile at. Better know exactly what the fuck they came to do. Oh, that hook. You want to talk about earworms? Listen to 1 millisecond of Body Yaddy 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 and it will never leave you. And this is the kind of earworm you would never want to leave you. Okay, sure, maybe you would find it a nuisance. But I don't. Body crazy, curvy, wavy, big titties, little waist. At the very least, I embrace our big titties, little waist overlords. That beat is just the popped cherry on top. Body crazy, curvy, wavy, big titties, little waist. Specifically, the moaning in the background. That's just awesome. Yeah, it may be a mindless stripper anthem, but it's the kind we could use more of in this age of COVID mania, when strip clubs get shut down and dancers have to work drive-through or, at the worst, sue the city. All my features been getting these niggas through the quarantine. We still have a long way to go, so some would say it might not be wise to have them reopen just yet, as my city has recently done. But hey, I couldn't think of any better real hot girl shit to welcome the pervs back to. Body yaddy 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 all day. Wait, body yaddy 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 yaddy. And now, some more stuff I had to leave off the list. I get those goosebumps every time. I need the hype. I will absolutely support Lithuanian bass remixes of old trap songs. I wonder what a remix of Unforgettable would sound like. The French Montana one, not the Nat King Cole one. That one would just sound fucking stupid. Falling in deep with the quicksand. Flag on my ass, no quick brand. There's something about this guy. I haven't been able to put my finger on it yet, but there's definitely potential here. I might need to listen to it a few more times, but I do hope it gets big in the coming months. Yeah, babe, I can put you on a flight. Alright, fine. It grew on me. But now it's really time to go away, Chris Brown. I like this better than their other one, for the record. It's got more of a groove to it. But I only had room for one good monster song on the list, and, well, hometown bias had to get the win, so... I heard he shot Turtlemaker beatbox. I'm kind of a little disappointed that there is no beatboxing in this, a track called Beatbox. But that being said, I kinda like the beat to it. I know there were some of you who were baffled that I didn't have it on my worst list, but the way I see it, it's just an average gangster rap song. I can't really be too mad at it. But no, we don't need three versions of the same song. Please give us something different. The guy's name is Pooh Shiesty. Yes, it's a stupid fucking name, but whatever. I've seen worse. Never forget the stupidity of Kaja Gugu. Never. And looking at this as a tune, I think it's got a pretty good charm to it. The video has some awesome green screen special effects as well. So yeah, stupid name, but as a whole, I would go as far as to call him the next Big Sean. Hey, Gwen Stefani is back! Yeah, this is an I'm Back Bitch single if there ever was one. And Blake Shelton isn't here to drag it down. Although, now that I think about it, maybe the two of them making an album together would be interesting, in a way. Still believing for days on. If there was a time to make something like this a big hit, it should be right now. Because goddammit, we still believe in good days. And once it's all over, we're gonna be swaying to this in our magical forest of oversized mushrooms. Or at least it'll feel like that. And with all that out of the way, let's go back up. Up, then it's up. If it's up, then it's stuck. If it's up, then it's up, then it's up, then it's stuck. Gotta play it safe, no face, no case. You know how sometimes you come across something and it's just so astoundingly beautiful that you're just at a loss for words? If you got it, it ain't a question. Oh, it ain't no one for guessing. I mean, just listen to it. All of it. Everything about this is majestic. The synths, the drums. Hell, especially this part. Well, best 1 second of music I've heard so far this year. I've said that I'm a sucker for the 80s R&B sounds, and this has that vibe in spades. Of course, that's because it's actually this. Yeah, it's basically this, but with different lyrics from a different singer. And we haven't even gotten to her yet. Oh, you're falling for me. Oh, baby, I caught it. I've always thought H.E.R. had potential, and goddamn does she sell it and then some. She takes that silly love song about making love in the rain and turns it into this. Be careful what you take for granted, yeah. A little warning to someone you're about to fall in love with. A plead for them to be careful with your heart, because if you're not, you could do damage. And let me tell you, that line really gets me in all of the feels. It's one thing to get your heart broken, but she takes it to property damage levels. You could do damage. So yeah, her sampling Herb. It works on so many levels. Right now it seems to be hanging in there in the middle of the charts, but I really hope it eventually lasts long enough to at least make the year end. If you want music to, like, really feel things to, this'll do it. Huh, look at that. A tear in my beer. Thank you.
nobody. I need me chat party. Don't invite me to no party. Bitch, pull up in that. It's so ooh. They ask how I get that. Ooh. I'm a hustler.